So guys, let's do start with introduction. So first of all, I would like to start introduction of mine. So this is Aftab, and this is from Koenig Solutions. I'm going to take this training of F5 GTM training. And if I do talk about myself, so I have a 10-year experience, including network security and including F5 products like LTM, GTM, and I used to do work on different projects, including network security firewalls and other stuff also, like F5, GTM, LTM, AFM, all these things. So in this training, we can work around on different things, like we do have to understand about F5, GTM, and we can also do focus on other stuff, like how we do build data center infrastructure, how we do use the things, and how we can do synchronize our full data center structure and everything. These things we have to understand theoretically as well practically. So guys, now we are going to start the training part. So let's do start with some fundamental stuff which you already have a knowledge, but it is good to start with the fundamentals, so we can do just quickly revise the DNS thing. So guys, in this training we do focus on mostly your DNS part. Let me first quickly explain about the DNS, how DNS work and how we can do understand the fundamentals of DNS and GTM DNS, and why we required this GTM. All these things we can understand. So I'm going to start with DNS basics, like how DNS work and how exactly we do send our DNS queries. The very first thing, like we have to understand the DNS basics or fundamental. See, DNS is your domain name system or domain name server. So DNS is not new thing. Like we are getting here in GTM. It's just a part of your server. So F5 product do come with the DNS services. Means F5 they integrated DNS things into a box and they do provide all DNS functions. Earlier we called it GTM, but nowadays like it's become your fully DNS box. It do provide all functions of DNS, including your all bind functions, zone runner records, zone transfer, and all types of records we can do create here in DNS. So all these things we are getting here on GTM nowadays. So GTM is not like only your global traffic manager. Now it's fully a DNS box. And apart from that, if I do talk about DNS fundamentals, so DNS is kind of directory which directory or database which resolve fully qualified domain name to corresponding IP addresses. So it's long list of database which actually do resolve the queries for particular FQDN based on the records which actually do have. Let's say you are trying to access particular website. So how exactly it do work? So you are trying to access particular website which is on internet. So if I do talk about local system perspective, so it do work like this. This is my machine or PC, and this machine actually connected with your, let's say, local device, router or modem, and you are trying to access a particular website which is on internet. This is your internet cloud. So let's suppose you are trying to access facebook.com. You are trying to access facebook.com or any website you are trying to access. So this is your name record, or this is your fully qualified, this is your domain name, which is facebook.com, www.facebook.com, or you just type facebook.com. So for this, whatever the DNS you do configure in your machine, let's say you do configure your DNS, which is global DNS 888. So it do redirect your query to modem, and then modem further redirect to query on DNS. And it do have actually certain steps to resolve the query. It's not directly goes on the DNS server. There is DNS hierarchy to resolve this query. So first, like how exactly we get the web page and how exactly we get the DNS IP. These two things we can correlate. When I do send any FQDN based or any name based query to DNS server, so DNS server will send it to, same query will send it to a root domain or root server, and then top level domain is there, and then second level, and then last is third or sub level. So this is actually hierarchy, which we can understand later, like how exactly it works. So normally for user perspective, when you do send any request to particular website, so you always get an answer. And how exactly it do work? You do query to your DNS server, and if DNS server do have a record, so it do answer. And moreover, if I do start from very beginning, so it do work like this. Your request goes to you do request to your DNS server. First, it do check your local cache. If there is any cache record, so it do reply quickly. So your query become a non-recursive, means you do get your query resolved quickly. It doesn't send or it doesn't forward it to anywhere. If it do not find your query, so it do send the query to DNS server, whichever DNS server you configure in your machine. Once you do send your query to DNS server will do check whether the local DNS server or your internet ISP DNS server will check whether the query is there or not. If there is query, so it do response. If there is no, if it's not available, so it do send into here on root domain. Root domain will further check out your query name. Like in my case, it is Facebook. So facebook.com. So it do send further request to top level domain, top level top level domain LTD. So it do check the category, and it is your commercial com category. So accordingly, it do check the com category, and then it respond back to second level DNS. Second level DNS keep all the records which is regarding your main domain name, like Facebook, Google, all these records we can get here in second level Yahoo. So it find two components like com and Facebook here. Now because I'm trying to open the page of Facebook, so how it look like exactly? So it look like www.facebook.com. So it do send it to third level. So here we get an entry www.facebook.com. So this is how exactly your DNS query resolved. And now once the query get resolved, so it do send it on the machine which is actually having the authoritative record. So authoritative record or machine which is having a file of particular record, it do resolve with fully qualified domain name. So let's say this machine or PC have a name which is PC1. So the fully qualified domain name will become pc1.ww1.facebook.com. So this is how your DNS query is resolved. Let me show you with proper diagram, then you can understand properly. Now suppose you are an employee within XYZ industry, and one of four clients in is in charge of network departments of X, and you type your browser, the address of department's web browser, www.net. com pci.google plex.edu. So see the very first thing, when you do type this query, so it check the cache to see if already has address of this name. If doesn't, it returns immediately to my browser. But in this case, we assuming that it doesn't. The resolver also check it to see the local host table files. It scan the files and see the name of static mapping. If so, resolve the name using the information immediately. Again, let's assume it doesn't, since we it would be boring. Like it means like if your host name already resolved the query, so it means you have a local cache. If local cache is not available, so it do send a resolver to generate a recursive query. So guys, we have to remember like one thing. Whenever any client do send a query to DNS servers, it always be like recursive query, means client get either answer or either get error. So there's two possibility, and there's two possibilities, either client get answer or client get error. So such queries we call recursive queries. Do you guys have idea about recursive and iterative queries, Malit?
Yeah. So I have a question, like the recursive query will recursive queries read by the local DNS server, no? So I am a PC, so when I'm trying to access that particular SQDN, I don't have a cache in my cache, and also there are no any record in the host. Then yes. I'm mirrored in the my DNS server. So DNS server also don't have. Then he is the one who doing the recursive query to the ISP level, no? So check in there.
Client, the source of origin will, let's say client is originating the query. So that query will be your recursive query from client perspective. All right.
Okay.
If DNS server is querying to another DNS server, so such queries we call iterative queries. Correct? Let's say if root DNS server or top level domain server querying to second level DNS server, so such queries we call iterative queries. Make sense? So two kinds of queries we have, recursive. So for client perspective, whenever we do send a query, so we always want answer. Like we don't want negative answer. It actually worked like this. I hope you guys can see my screen. Let's suppose you are trying to send query from this client machine, just to show you. If you do send any query to a DNS server from a PC, let's say you are querying for abc.com or xyz.com. So for client perspective, it is recursive query. Means client do not want negative answer from want revert back a query again. Like if it do not have answer, so it straightforward says it cannot like say to go on any other DNS server. The DNS server itself cannot answer to client for any other DNS server, correct?
Yeah.
It can give answer or it can give error. So there's two possibilities in recursive queries. But let's say this DNS server do not have answer, so it can do forward the query to other DNS server. Like it do not have answer, so it is actually following, let's say, hierarchy of DNS. So the request will forward it to root domain, and then root domain will further check the name record and it do send it to top level domain, and top level domain will send it to second level, then send it to third level, or we can say sub level, and then we find the record, and once we have a record, so we can do access the website.
So it is like the if Facebook, so the recursive resolver sending the dot com, he need to understand where is the dot com is there, then it is going
yes,
to the root
yes.
name server, then yes. root name server reply to the recursive resolver like dot com is there, you need to this is the dot com resolving part, then you need to contact the TLD, top level domain
yes.
server for the dot com, no? So
yes correct. See, this diagram will help out. This is a clear-cut picture, so let me just copy into int and we can explore further. See, this diagram have a very clear understanding like how it exactly work. Let me explain it. Let's suppose you are sitting here on N machine, endpoint or client machine, and you are trying to browse particular website, correct? So first you do send request to resolver here. It do check, means your local resolver, it do check whether we have a updated cache or check for cache. If there is no cache or if there is no host record for particular query, so it do send recursive query. See, the very next step is recursive query. And then further, it goes to the local DNS server. Like if I'm running local DNS server, which is let's say 888 or any address like 4.2.2, we do not have these global DNS servers. So we can use our local infrastructure DNS server, which is let's say 192.168.1.1. This is my local DNS server. So there can be two possibilities, either local DNS server we are using or global. So let's say here we are using LDNS server local. It also check for the cache. If there is no cache, so it send it to root name server. So root name server is the server which is at the top in hierarchy of DNS. It's a standard process. When your local DNS server do not have a query, your DNS server not have an answer for the query, so it do send the query to root. So such queries we call iterative query. It is doing iterative query here. So I do check the name, like which website you are trying to use. So let's say you are trying to access facebook.com, for example. So here I do check the top level names. Top level names, like the very last part comes under top level, like edu, com, in, co, uk, in. These things actually come under top level. So I do, in my case, it name server for edu. So it send a request for the edu to here on top level. So it is again iterative query. So guys, you can remember, when any DNS server do request to DNS server, so such queries we call iterative queries. So it comes to here on top level DNS server, and then it do check, and it find here edu, and then again it send it to next DNS, next level DNS, which is your second level. So it do find here next part of the name, like Facebook, or in my case, in this example, googleplex.edu. So facebook.com, that's actually come with second level, this name records. And further, you check for the third level, you can say. So it comes to the actual a record for which you created, like you created this for www.facebook.com. So here you get actually your answer.